I'm Kobi Zamir and I work at Reddit. We're going to talk about home automation. I hope we'll get to home automation, but we'll talk about mainly about pymodbus. Pymodbus is a communication protocol. We're going to talk about why we are doing home automation. We're going to talk about automation, what it is, what we can do with it. We're going to talk about technologies, because Modbus is not the usual suspect when you go to home automation. You usually will go with buses, with queues, like MQT, if someone knows about it. And we're going to talk about Python, why doing this with Python. Then we're going to show some cool stuff that I hope will work. I know that some of it work because I tried it before, and I know that some doesn't work also because I tried it before. And that's it. So I'm a software engineer at Red Hat, and today I'm going to talk about automation, which is more relevant to my last job. At my last work, at my previous work, I worked, I built controllers, industrial controllers, which is not exactly what you want to use for your home, but it works. So about 4 years ago, my heater controller broke down and I needed a replacement. So you can go and buy a new controller for your heater, which is fine, but I work at industrial controller, so I can do it. And I wanted to use free software and free hardware and free protocols. So what is automation? The idea of automation, a lot of you do automation for software, but automation is looking at getting some input from the environment and doing stuff. So we have a picture of a orange thing I can't show. It takes input from the environment and do random stuff. It's not helpful. And then we have a mechanical controller, which is also fine. It takes input from the environment, the time. We take input from the environment and we do stuff. And then we have what we call controllers, which are things that also take input from the environment and do stuff, but they're also connected to something that we can control using a UI. And now we need to implement it. And what we are going to talk is about how you implement those things. You can use technologies, the newest stuff, and you can use what's good for what you need. And what I'm talking about here is about communication. There are new stuff about communication, especially when you're talking about TCP and Ethernet. You have queues, which are wonderful things. Queues are things that you can take a lot of input from the from controllers and queue them and distribute them into listeners. But for my home, I didn't need those. For my home, I needed to turn on the heater, close the heater, turn on the lights, close the lights. It shouldn't have come in. It should have stayed off. Okay. And sense temperature, water the garden. For those things, I don't need a queue. And that's where Modbus goes in. Modbus is a very simple protocol for communicating between devices. So why Python? Well, you can do everything with Python, so why not? And PyModbus is the implementation of the Modbus protocol, which is the protocol I chose for my automation. And you need hardware. You need things that will start thing, close thing, sense the environment and decide what to do and give you a UI about what how to do it. And you need a UI. Okay, so there are a lot of UIs that you can use, but most of them are very hard. You need to write HTML and write the server yourself. I actually had for 2 years a Flask server that did the UI, but it's hard to do, it's hard to maintain. So you have software that does this for you. Some of them are extremely complicated, and Node-RED is exactly in the middle. It's not hard to use, and it's does the job. So we get into what we talked about. So we talked about Modbus, which is a protocol to talk between devices. It's a simple protocol. It's easy to implement. Little controllers can speak it, and it's nice. We're talking about free hardware. I used for this for doing this a Raspberry Pi, which is a very small computer. It's cheap. It's about 120 shekels, and it operates like a big computer. It can do anything a big computer does. It takes little electricity, and it does the job. It's small factor. You can push it in your electric box, and it does the job. And Arduinos are even smaller controllers. They don't have TCP. They are very small, very cheap, about 10 shekels each, and they have a much powerful ways of controlling things. The current they can hold is much bigger than the Raspberry Pi. So they are intended to be the end device, the device that does things. Open a light, close light, open the off, start the heater, close the heater. And you need a UI, a nice UI, and Node-RED is very, very nice in the way that it's in the middle. It's not a hard to do UI, and it's not a simple UI. So what I plan now is the showing the things. Why you need communication between controllers? The idea is you have several controllers, and you want the big one, usually the Raspberry Pi, to control the other, to tell them start, stop. And because you don't want to use Ethernet is problematic in home environment if you don't want to use Wi-Fi. If you want to use Wi-Fi, it's great. But if you don't, you have a problem with Ethernet. It's expensive, and it needs maintenance. It needs routers and switches. On the other hand, serial communication, like Modbus, is cheaper, and it's easier to wire up. So I will go back because...
So you physically wired all the controllers to the Raspberry Pi?
Yes. The current version is the Raspberry Pi does everything. But in the beginning, it was like that. You have a small Arduino, another small Arduino, another. And it, in the end, it will get into a Raspberry Pi, not a computer. I wanted to show the Raspberry Pi here, but it turns out it doesn't have a screen, so I couldn't see what you are seeing. So in the end, it will connect to a Raspberry Pi that will do the logic, when to start, when to stop, and things like that. Anyone knows the distance that Ethernet can, you can do point-to-point Ethernet, the distance? 100 meters. So a serial RS485 can do 1500 kilometer and a half. And serial device, you can also daisy chain devices, which is something you can't do with Ethernet. Ethernet, you need a switch if you want several devices, and the simpler protocols can do up to 30 devices on one line. I wanted to check that. Anyone knows what Modbus is, because I moved too fast, I think. So anyone understand what Modbus is? Nobody understand. So the protocol for serial communication is called Modbus. One of the protocols for serial communication is called Modbus, and this one specific is easy to implement, it's royalty free, and it's easy to use. Okay, so we're going to the demo. We have here two input devices, which are a cat detector and a thermometer. And we have two output devices, which are a light control and colorful lights. And that's what we are going to show you. Do you feel like a cat?
No. No. Okay. So come and look into the cat. That's it. Okay. So you're very cat. Okay, you can sit. I have a problem.
I tweaked all yesterday to tweak it only to see cats, but it sees people too. And sometimes nothing. Maybe it sees the first row. I will point it somewhere out. I will point it somewhere it can see the first row. I get stuck in the fan. It's overclocked and it's... So now... Okay, no. Anyway, it should have seen only cats. I will show. I have a cat reference here, so I can sell. And you can trust me that it should have seen only cats. So these are not humans, these are cats. It's a reference. And if I will show it cats, oh. It doesn't like me. I sacrificed a goat on Saturday, but it didn't help. Oh, okay. Yes, it's when you do live demos, if you do, you have to. Did you see that it showed? I'll show you again. So these are cats, and it can see cats. Okay, so what we saw here is a Raspberry Pi. Inside here, there's a Raspberry Pi. And it senses the environment, and when it sees a cat, it opens the light, and it should not open light for humans. For example, if you hook it up to your cat door, you want it only to open your cat door and not the big door. And that's a cat detector, and I will show live demos. I forgot the power for the other Arduino, so I will start with the flashing light. So what we have here is a long line. The idea of this demonstration, I will show that it's a long line. It's a long line, okay? So there's a long line. And what I want to show is how you control things. I really, really hope it works, because it didn't really work earlier. So what I'm going to do is try to change the lights. It's Python. Anyone can see that it's Python? And okay, so as you know, you can do everything in Python, and one of the things you can do with Python, except anti-gravity, if anyone wants to levitate, it can communicate over lines. And what you see here, I'm really happy it worked because it didn't really work earlier. So one of the things about Modbus, it's robust and it works. So when you see here that things doesn't work, it's not like that when you do things correctly. I bought the cheapest line possible and it's long and my connections are not that good. And I forgot the power line for one of the controllers, but it does work. It's much more reliable than other ways of doing things. So what you do is import the Modbus library, and then you connect. What you see is that USB is I connected this line to USB connector. So it's serial on USB, and you connect to your controllers. You can connect to up to 31 controllers in one. I will write it. Sorry. I can't write? Okay. And you can connect, and then you can change the light. Lights. Do you like red? You the one that hide. Do you like the color red? Okay. So we'll do it red. We'll do full red, and that one is green. And it should, as I said, it doesn't work. I connected and it was. Don't do live demos. Oh. Yes, I intentionally did it not working, so it will be like it's not a big thing, it's just. And another color, another yellow, red, green, and blue. How do you do yellow? It's red and green, right? Let's try. I don't. Almost yellow. So this is how you control things, but as we say, you need also to sense the environment. And because I forgot the power line, I will have to, so the light will stop. It's this one has a unit ID of one. You can daisy chain them on one line, so you need to have an ID for each controller. This one is one, and I'm going to read and not write. IPython, you have to like it. Anyone use IPython? Ah, okay, so it's great. And what I'm going to do is try to read. And it doesn't work, slowly. Okay, so, it's very cold here. Anyone feels cold? It's 17 degrees Celsius here. So this device sends temperature. and it says it's 70 degrees. And I have a loop here. I did have a loop here. Oh, okay. So what this loop does is read this device and tell the temperature. I will try to make it warm. Everyone wants to hug this device. I will try. I will give it a lot of love. I'm a warm person. So now we can stop it. So what we showed is that I like the lights. I will put the lights back on. So let's see if we can change the lights. The yellow is too yellow for me. Red, green, blue. I want blue. Okay. Yes, thank you. You are very good at code reviews. And it's not working. So my code need reviews. I forgot. Okay. No, I think I broke the connection. As I said, it needs to be connected correctly. Okay, great. I'm so happy that you showed me that. So we'll stop now because it stopped working. And questions.
What is the operating system you use on the Raspberry Pi?
I use Raspbian. It's not exactly free, but it's leaning towards free. Fedora and Debian have the drivers are not the same. If you saw that I have problem with Wi-Fi here, if you use Raspbian, it will usually work, and if you use Fedora and Debian, it will also work. But Raspbian. Yes, so we move forward. Next question. You. He asked if it will work with MicroPython. It should work with MicroPython. I use C, it's easier, and it does the job. So that's it. MicroPython, anyone knows what MicroPython is? Okay, so MicroPython is a small footprint Python that you can do on embedded devices. No, I didn't try. It should work with MicroPython, I didn't try. Yes, next question.
What have you automated at your home?
So, at my home, I will show the first. The first slide was photos I took in my home. So what you see here is irrigation. You shouldn't do irrigation like that. You need a pressure controller before the valve. What you see here is an electric valve for irrigation. When it gets 24 volts, it opens and it irrigates whatever is connected. And when it doesn't, it simply closes the line. The next thing, the one that looks like electric open thing, this one connects a water heater. Water heaters are more complicated because they need a lot of current. They need 10 amps. And usual electric switches are rated at 10 amps max. So this is a 40 amp, which will be okay for 10 amp in the water heater. And the last thing is another controller that controls the gates in parking. So what I did, I didn't really do the controlling and only connected to this controller and tell him open the gate and close the gate. And lights are simple. Lights are what you see, the little round blue things. They are 10 amps and they can do lighting whenever you want. Yes.
Is there any authentication before you?
Great. So when you're talking industrial controllers, you don't want to be connected to the internet. Nothing. You don't have security and you're not connected to the internet. But Ethernet have the tendency to get connected. Someone want to connect it, and these lines are not internet. You will not connect them to the internet. And if you are really scared about the security, you will put the lines themselves inside the metal enclosures so no one can tap on these lines. So the security is physical security and not software security. If someone will break into the network of these lines and get into a box, a controlling box, and clamp in, he will know everything. So no security at all. If you bypass all the physical security.
Simon, what's the hardware background you need for a project like that?
Ah. Until 24 volts, you can't kill yourself. So if you are below 24 volts, fine. If you want to do 200, you need a license from the state, electrician license. That depends how much you love yourself and you love other people. But you can do it.
Thank you.
And the little things, the Arduinos and Raspberry Pi, you can play with them and you don't need any background. They are really cute things. They are cute things. You can't hurt yourself. You see, it's cute. And it's 5 volts and it's a lot of fun and it's easy. And if you buy, there's a nice store of someone that was, I think she was Israel. So there's an Adafruit, and she sells these things with all the instructions. And it's not, it's play kits. And it's, she's called Adafruit. It's yes, and you don't need any background because she explains do that, do that, do that, and it about 99.9 works. I'm told I don't have any more time, so